Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to create this very popular white outlined picture that you see in thumbnails or images on the internet. So you could do this in Photoshop or GIMP, but it's also very easy and quick to do in HitFilm. Here's what you're going to do. You're going to start by making a new composite shot, and this will be the source picture. You will want to create an embedded composite shot, pre-composed as it were. I'm going to bring in my picture. Now, either I will mask it out one way, or the other way would be to key it out, and that's what I'm going to do here. So I'm just going to use a basic green screen key, and then I'm going to create a garbage mask here. Then I will key the rest out, okay? Either way, however you do it, you ultimately want a picture that is transparent behind the picture of what you want. So in other words, the alpha information is in there. So now I'm going to create a new composite shot. This will be the final, and I will bring in my picture. This is important that this is baked into its own composite shot, okay? Now I'm going to add a new plane layer and bring it down below the picture. And to that plane layer, I'm going to add a couple of effects. One is I'm going to add the set matte effect. And then I will use as the source the picture. So essentially, it is just an outline of that same picture. Then the second thing, and this is really the secret sauce of this technique, is the neon glow effect. I'm going to add that in. And you'll see right away that we have this here, okay? Now notice that there's a little bit of an edge here, okay? The reason is because the plane ends right here. So if you were to take the transform properties and increase this to say 110%, then it will increase the size of it enough that it won't have a problem, getting all the way to the edge, okay? From here, under the neon glow, what I will do is I'll go ahead and ramp up the intensity to the max, and then I'm going to take the expansion down to 0 and take the radius down to 0. From here, I can just bring the expansion up until I'm happy with it, okay? So that sort of depends on your picture, your shot, right? I'm going to go with about there in this particular shot. Now, if I want, I can add a background. I'll use my plane again. And I will just throw in, say, a color gradient effect. And if I feel like it, maybe I'll go, say, blue to red or something like that. So you can see how the outline is here. Now, that outline can be any color you want it to be. You just open up the neon glow and change it to something else. Usually, though, you want that to be white, okay, just so you know, right? And that's it. It's really that simple. All you have to do now is just options and export the frame to a PNG file. If you want to convert it using, in Windows, you could use Paint to convert it to a JPEG. Or if you want to just leave it as a PNG, you can do it that way too. But it's really that simple. So if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.